beta and the gamma function part 2. Now the beta function, as we discussed earlier, beta mn is what? Integration 0 to 1 x raised to power m minus 1 x minus 1 raised to power n minus 1 dx. So that integral we write beta mn. So there are some basic properties of the beta function. The first one, beta function is symmetric, that is beta mn is equal to beta nm. And the second property, it's integration 0 to 1 x raised to power n minus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to power m plus n dx is equal to beta mn. And the third integral, that is third property, 2 integration 0 to pi by 2 sine theta raised to power 2 m minus 1 cos theta is to power 2 n minus 1 d theta is also right beta mn. So there are three basic properties. Now we discuss the proof of this property. So the first property is what? Beta function is a symmetric, that is beta mn is equal to beta n. How to prove that property? As we know, beta mn we write 0 to 1 integral x raised to power m minus 1 1 minus x raised to power n minus 1 dx. Now we know the property of the integration, that is integration, if we have an integration 0 to a fx dx, so it can be written as 0 to a f a minus x dx. So by using that property in that integral, so here a is what? 1. So we write 0 to 1, and on the place of x we write 1 minus x raised to power m minus 1 1 minus x whole power n minus 1 dx. Now 0 to 1, 1 minus x raised to power m minus 1, and we write x raised to power n minus 1 dx. Now if we see that integral can be written 0 to 1 x raised to power n minus 1 1 minus x raised to power m minus 1 dx. So that integral is written as beta. First we write n, then m. So we can say beta mn is equal to beta nm. Next property, beta mn is equal to integration 0 to infinity x raised to power n minus 1 1 plus x raised to power m plus n dx. So now how to prove that property? So as you know, beta mn is equal to 0 to 1 x raised to power m minus 1 1 minus x raised to power n minus 1 dx. Now here we just put x is equal to 1 upon 1 plus y and differentiate both sides. So we write dx is equal to minus 1 upon 1 plus y whole square dy. Now we put in that equation 1. So here the limit would be, if we put 0 in the place of x, so we get y is equal to infinity, and when we put 1 is, so we get y is equal to 0. So from equation 1, beta mn, the limit become infinity to 0. We are substituting x is equal to 1 upon 1 plus y raised to power m minus 1 and 1 minus 1 upon 1 plus y whole power n minus 1, and on the place of dx we write minus 1 upon 1 plus y whole square dy. Now if we interchange the upper and lower limit, so we get a negative sign, and negative sign negative become positive, so we write 0 to infinity, and on that place if we are taking the LCM over here, so we write 1 plus y minus 1, that is y. So we can write y raised to power n minus 1 1 plus y raised to power m minus 1 1 plus y raised to power n minus 1 and 1 plus y whole square dy. Now beta mn is equal to, we write 0 to infinity y raised to power n minus 1, and if we add all the power m minus 1, n minus 1, plus 2, so we can write 1 plus y whole power m plus n, and minus 1 minus 1 become minus 2 plus 2, so we get m plus n dy. So as you see, we prove that property, beta mn is equal to, we can write 0 to infinity, and the variable y raised to power n minus 1 plus 1 upon y raised to power m plus n dy. The third property, 2 integration 0 to 2 pi sine 2 sine theta raised to power 2 m minus 1 cos theta raised to power 2 n minus 1 d theta become beta mn. So if you want to prove that property, so first we take beta mn is what, 0 to 1 x raised to power m minus 1, 1 minus x raised to power n minus 1 dx. Now you just substitute x is equal to sine square theta, and dx become 2 sine theta cos theta d theta. We just substitute in that integral 1, we get beta mn is equal to, limit is also changed, so when we put 0 here, so we get 0 limit, and when we put 1, so we get pi by 2, and on the place of x we put sine square theta, so we write sine square theta whole power m minus 1, 1 minus sine square theta whole power n minus 1, and on the place of dx we write 2 sine theta cos theta d theta. So we write 2 0 to pi by 2, that's become 2 m minus 2 and plus 1, it becomes sine 2m minus 1 theta, and that's can be write cos square theta, and so again we get cos theta whole square 2n minus 1 d theta. So that way we can prove them the property. So please remember these three properties, we can use these relation directly in the examples.